course, it wasn't all bad news, with Filipinos making their mark in the international stage. But are we in for another whirlwind year this 2012?
I'm curious to know myself. Now, here to tell us about her forecast for the new year is astrologer Paloma. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi.
All right.
Thank you for having me here.
Thank you for joining us.
Happy New Year.
We were talking, first and foremost, Happy New Year. We were talking about what, 2011 was a very challenging year for us here in the Philippines, for Filipinos. And 2012 is going to be what, in your opinion? What are we in for in 2012?
Well, we're in for massive changes. Mm-hmm. People say that I always bring bad news, okay? Mm-hmm. And that's not the case, really. Nobody wants to really look at bad news. But with my job as an astrologer, I look into problems and see, so that we can see how do we go about it. Mm-hmm. At the least, how do we survive and how do we ride with it? Because all the given things in the chart, the good things, are there already. You know, like for example, they say that West is a very good direction this year. And it's very lucky. You don't even have to mind it, because whether you activate that or not, it will give you luck. It's there. It's given.
Okay.
And the best thing you could do is just use that particular direction as often as you could. Mm-hmm. But the problems, these are the Filipinos are not used to solving problems. Mm-hmm. And I would like to help in my own little way to make them look at the problems and do something about it. It's about time we do that.
Mm-hmm. So does it seem as if there are going to be more problems this year as opposed to last? Or
problems, yes. Challenges, shall challenges, we call them?
Yeah, well... we can call it by whatever term, but the point is we can see them happening, you know.
Actually, you were talking about a long lead up to the where we are now,
and
it's been a while happening, and it's about time that we start focusing on those signs that point to where we are now.
Okay, it's not only celebrities that do trending; the planets do trending also,
right.
And from 2000, the planets started not getting along with each other, and every time they fight we get caught in between, you know, us above, so below. So from 2000 we could see already the start of the breaking down of systems and structures. The planets are trying to tell us that all these things are now obsolete, not contributing to growth anymore, they are outmoded, and we are in line for changes. So so there you could see it building up. And then in 2008 until 2010, those years were highly on a highly transformative mode. Okay, as a matter of fact, until now we are still reeling from the planetary effects of those events. Okay, last year was the year where we were ushered into the new era. It was the beginning of a transition into a new era. And so it will continue next year, okay? So what do we expect? Massive changes. Massive changes in the political arena, economic arena, crisis ecologically. Still, you know, expect to see more floods, more tsunamis, cold spells, possible problems in food supply.
Right. Water, you said, was looking to be somewhat of a problem or a challenge that we're looking at.
Yes, because water is the major element ruling the year next year. Mm-hmm. And there's just a lot of water. Mm-hmm. Because there are two influences that will provide water. So in other words, if there will be a lot of water, then you can see the scenario of floods again, deadly floods, tsunamis, a lot of people getting displaced again. You have to remember that transformation, the only road to transformation is ruin. Mm-hmm. And when there is ruin, there's death. Mm-hmm. And death is the one that ushers in a new beginning or new births.
When is this new beginning supposed to take place on the on
it's
the
taking place already. It's just that elements are taking turns in giving us how they work, contributing to the changes that we need. So
when you say water is something that you see a lot of, coming, is that something that... can you use that to an advantage somehow? Does it have to be so much water that it's going to be a problem in terms of, you know, floods, tsunamis, or disasters. Is there a way to harness that abundance and make it something that is a little more positive?
Well, the only thing I can say is maybe review your spiritual standing. Mm-hmm. Maybe because that is one of the things required, some spiritual evaluation. Mm-hmm. Too much of anything is deadly, okay? Right. Too much water is deadly. And when we talk of too much water, let's also include tears. Mm-hmm. So tears will come into our personal lives, okay? How do we harness it? We don't need to harness it. There's just too much of it. The problem is there might be contaminated water. Mm-hmm. And then if water is contaminated, there will be less to drink. Mm-hmm. So we really have to prepare. Mm-hmm. We really have to prepare how to purify water, whether we can afford to buy a purifier or we can do the ancient way of doing it, mm-hmm. you know. We have to learn to prepare.
Well, I mean, you mentioned earlier there will be massive changes in the political arena and the economic arena. Maybe changes in the economic arena would be a good thing right now. Is there a possibility?
Yes,
that
because
there's so much negative news coming from that side, the change would be positive.
Actually, the motivation of the planets is to alter power and influence. Mm-hmm. Okay, so you see all kinds of governments will start changing. Mm-hmm. And we see it now, you know, in Israel, Pakistan, you name it. Even Obama is forced to change. Mm-hmm. You know, here, well, I don't need to say anything. You could see the rumblings, you know, you could hear the rumblings really bad, you know. And it's also a way of karmic collection. Mm-hmm. See, I've said this many years ago that karma will start collecting. Mm-hmm. And all the corruptions will be brought out in the open, whether we like it or not. No matter how powerful you are, it will come out and mm-hmm. it will stink, mm-hmm. you know. And it's gonna get you. So I think that's what's happening right now.
Are there major major events, say, particularly for us, what major events can people look towards in what part of the year in 2020?
The critical months that I see are February, June, and July.
February, birthday ko yun. That's
July,
a major
birthday
event.
Ko pa naman yun. Okay.
Those are major events.
Okay.
All right.
Go ahead.
February, June, and July. Mm-hmm. Now, you see, the chart of the year contains a lot of water, but a very little earth and hardly fire, okay? Mm-hmm. So, in the context of balancing things, which is actually the teaching of the universe, everything should be balanced. Mm-hmm. Any element missing or has a very little supply of will try to make up for it, okay? So, it gets exacerbated. Mm-hmm. So, if there's little earth, what to expect from Earth? Earthquakes, okay? Volcanic eruptions, mm-hmm. okay? So expect that. Expect that to happen, okay? And fire, oh, well, that's literal, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, last year, Japan was hit, okay? All the malevolent tendencies of the energies, they get concentrated in particular directions. Mm-hmm. Last year was east. Mm-hmm. And tending towards the northeast, mm-hmm. and guess what country got it?
Okay.
Smack right on east, and tending northeast was Japan. Mm-hmm. This year, because last year the bad energy was in the east, okay, the malevolent energy as we call it. This year, these negative energies will be in the southeast, mm-hmm. and north, tending towards northwest, okay. So now, if you think southeast, so people in the southeastern area of the whole world mm-hmm. need to take care, need to really, really be serious about preparing for this, mm-hmm. okay? And guess who is in the southeast? That includes us.
Okay.
So I will not discount the fact that we might get hit, maybe probably worse than Japan, okay? Remember, we are, I'm not the only one saying this, we are third in the most vulnerable countries for calamities,
right.
Okay? So, and then any southeast of the world, mm-hmm. like Florida in the stage, you know, any southeast direction will get affected. Now, southeast also represents the eldest daughter in the family. So the eldest daughters can have problems, disastrous problems, okay?
Does it count if you're an only child? Because I could be the youngest too if I choose. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, so we can see the directions. They can be qualified, so we can know where to prepare the most, okay? Last year, one of the, aside from east, another direction that was really bad was south. And guess what happened to our south?
True.
See?
When you say, you talk about transformation and change, I mean, it's not, often people don't like the change, and things like catastrophes, disasters, are sort of a
they
change.
Force us.
They force us to change. I mean, what is the blue skies on the horizon after all the challenge and change that we have to go through, which unfortunately brings a little bit of pain and a little bit of sadness. But at the end of all this transformation and change, surely there is something to look forward to?
Yeah, of course, there will always be something to look forward to. If we learn how to cope with these disasters, then we get to know ourselves better, because only adversity can teach us who we really are. We can learn from that. We can learn to recover our dignity. We can learn to recover our self-reliance. And probably when we do that, then we know now we can be wise enough to choose who to vote, you know, and how to run a good family, how to be a better family person, and how to behave better in a community. And all this put together, we could come up with a new way of living in this country.
No better time to do it than
I really need to sneak this in, because I just want to see if there's something very quickly that's going to be a massive change in show business, or as far as celebrities, anything that we can watch out for on that spectrum.
I haven't really looked into that as far as that is concerned.
Okay.
I am more, you know,
like holistic.
Bigger picture.
Yes, that's right. That's right.
Well, like I said, I mean, no better time to start.
February, June, and July are definitely the months to watch out for. Paloma, thank you so much for
you're most welcome.
For being here, and Happy New Year.
Happy New Year too. I hope we survive 2012.
All right.
Well,
stay tuned. When we come back, we'll take a peek at Robert Pattinson's new drama, Bella.